here. Usually I'm here, and then you're closing. Father, thank you again for our third service this afternoon, and Lord, I pray you be with us, and be in protection about the services, and Lord, as we head off into Monday, pray you will be done with all that. With the spirit world, you get these we went over this quite a bit, actually. You have the Eldorados and Atlantis, you know, these missing worlds. And of course, we went over last week in the book of Revelation about how God gives you a description, amen, Paul, rather, as he wrote about New Jerusalem, amen. And so that would have been Revelation chapter 22. Peter, 2 Peter chapter 3 said, nevertheless, we, according to his promise, look for a new heavens and a new earth wherein dwells righteousness. And of course, you always get the counterfeits there, and that's where they are always looking for the fountain of youth, Aquaman and all the rest of that crazy deal. The probably the most popular one that led America into a lot of what you see today as far as its level of the occult, different things could have been, your Wizard of Oz. I remember as a kid in Miami, whatever time of year they'd show that, I think it was Thanksgiving or something, and man, it was as a little kid, that movie, it was okay for some of it, but when that witch showed up and them flying monkeys, as a kid, I would get up and go. I'd go to my room for a little bit, and when those things pull out stuff and that, excuse me, the scarecrow guy. Alright, so the Wizard of Oz, alright, somewhere over the rainbow. The elements in the Wizard of Oz powerfully fill, the Wizard of Oz and the occult roots, rather, of the Wizard of Oz. And the guy says that the elements in the Wizard of Oz powerfully fill a void that exists inside many children. All right, now here's the problem with this. And so the devil knows that. He's the god of this world. And this void, we had talked about the gap, or, leading to your salvation, you had trusted Christ because you knew something was missing, right? So you had tried what the world offered. So you have the sex, drugs, the rock and roll lifestyle. Although that's wrong, the way the chronological order of that phrase is wrong. So it's not sex, drugs, rock and roll. It's rock and roll, drugs, and then that. Then the fornication. That's how that works, brother. So when it comes to little kids, the first thing the devil's going to introduce is that music. As far as leading you down that rabbit hole. So the problem that people have today, especially Christians that grew up in that lifestyle, most of the guys that have issues with the flesh in that respect is with music. So and I'm that guy too, in essence. I can't, that's what bothers me when I'm in quote-unquote Christian services and they play that music, knowing what that did to me. And I'm not going to blame all that, just life. I've got it. That's what everybody's going through. That's what the devil in Ezekiel chapter 20 is. When you read about Lucifer's pre-incarnation as far as before the fall, he's created with history. Barry Manilow writes a song, or somebody wrote it, and he's saying, I write a song. And when I was a kid, that's my mother's music, Barry Manilow. And I remember in Pensacola watching, I guess it was my day off or whatever, and I was watching Barry Manilow being interviewed. And he says, most people think that song is about me. I write the songs, make the whole world sing. He says, it isn't about me. And I'm like, oh, okay. Because I've heard that. I remember the most of the lyrics, not all of them, most of them. And then he went on to explain to whoever it was, Oprah Winfrey or Merv Griffin or whoever those guys were. And he said, if you listen to the lyrics, what that is, it's the spirit's muse, right? So in Greek mythology, you would say that these guys would tap into their muse, right? This musical spirit. So you get the word music,
right?
Muse, music. And so that's the influence. That's, you know, when you read about Led Zeppelin, and they ask, well, how did you come up with Stairway to Heaven? And they come up with these stories about, well, we don't know. A lot of those big songs and whatever, and you ask them during the interviews, and you read about, well, what's the history behind that? And a lot of those, like, I don't know. Well, we were just sitting there, me and Jimmy Page were sitting there, and we were trying to come up with some whatever for Led Zeppelin, our next album, and it just started coming to us. Hmm. And it's like, you know, Stairway to Heaven, if you're in that genre, it's like the number one rock song in the history. But they can't explain where that comes from, how that comes. So your Bible says all scripture is given by inspiration, right? So there's an inspiration there that's out there. There's two sides to the coin. So there's the Holy Spirit of God, and then there's what we're going over now. So you got seraphim, cherubim, angels, principalities, powers, rulers of darkness, wicked spirits, thrones, dominions, fallen angels, elders, devils, the devil, amen. And that's just the dark side of things. Amen. Well, that's more than dark. They have seraphim and cherubim, right? So that's a spiritual side of things. You have basically two classes of these and things that are not seen, the good and evil side of it. So that's why it's very important as a Christian. You're like, well, I have an idea. So Paul says, prove all things. You know, yeah? Where are you getting that idea from? You know, say a little bird thing. All right, so when it comes to that level of inspiration, these guys like Steven Spielberg and whatever, and they're coming up with these ideas and these movies, it just grows millions of dollars, man. And you just like, wow, that's it. You know, E.T. and all these different things. And it's usually a theme. Like, Stephen King will have a theme. That's all he writes about, is unclean spirits. And you're getting these kids, right? So now these little kids are coming in and they're being seduced, man. So as a young boy, I was seduced by that music. It started there. And a guy introduced me, and, you know, I'll get down that list of whoever it was, but, you know, and then it goes on from the music, and then it'll go to the drugs, and then everything that you've been singing about, and that's what it ends up. And then mom and dad are like, what happened to Junior? Well, you were the one who bought him all the stuff. I mean, I remember where I got my, I didn't have money, and I remember where it came from. No disrespect to my folks, but that's what the world does. And so in our school, our Christian school there, you know, you got these earphones, these earbuds, AirPods, whatever they're called. And I know what's going on. Hey, listen, what do you think they're listening? And then, you know, we got all these complaints about, well, the kids aren't listening, they're falling asleep, or whatever. I said, well, take the ear deals away. I mean, even in Sunset Senior High School, over there, that's a public school over there off of Kendall, off of Sunset Drive, whatever. We weren't allowed to bring the Walkmans. And I had a guy, the wrestling coach, our weight trainer guy, named Coach Almeida. And we'd be like most, and we'd try to sneak him in and whatever, and he would snatch him off. And well, he did me, and I had my, you know, Sony Walkman back in the day, and, you know, the wire and the gravity. He told us what he was going to do, don't bring him. And of course, we don't listen to anybody unless, like, Christians. I didn't know that. I thought Christians did this. But anyway. So he took him, and, you know, you go get him after school. So come back after school, you know, and the wire to your Walkman is, you know, 4 or 5 foot. Well, when he gave it to me, it was about like that. And he had tied knots in it, about 200 knots in my ear. And what you gonna do about nothing? So we took all the ear pods and whatever. The girls were coming in, and they had their hair over it. And then you ask a question, they wouldn't respond. And I say, pull your hair back. You know, throw it in their mouth or whatever they were talking. So it took away, but it was like a bunch of junkies. They were all shaking, all the kids, and I don't know what to do. But music's a drug, but the most pop. Matter of fact, music is associated with your image in the Book of Daniel. So the Book of Daniel talks about the image of music, and you know that in the 80s, and I've drawn this, I think, before, but that's what you have here. Music, television, that's music with an image. So the Antichrist is coming in and associated and hearing music, so you can't watch a movie without music. The big deal is the music.
Right.
Alright, so the elements of the Wizard of Oz powerfully fill the void that exists inside many children. The void. Now I look at Leviticus chapter 10. Alright, so I would agree with this guy that yeah, there is a void, but you know, be careful. Now what is it you're allowing your kids? So if the Bible's right, you're supposed to train up a child, correct? Yeah. Right? So if you have a folk, you're just going to allow your, you wouldn't allow him to constantly walk up to the stove and put his face on it. You would do whatever you would to try to convert that or intervene. But yet when it comes to music, for whatever reason, the parents, here's a phone. Man, phones ain't phones anymore. Phones only part of what that is. They use all that for anything but. There's really not a whole lot of people, brother. I mean, adults pretty much still use it, but kids don't talk on the phone. They text and they see and they print and they paste and they send. And I don't want to get all into what they're sending, brother, but, you know, we've had to suspend some kids or expel kids in our Christian school because of what they were sending each other, amen, on their phones. And I'm glad that technology didn't invent it, wasn't invented, you know, when I was growing up, because I would have used it too. All right, so Leviticus chapter 10, verse 10. And that you may put difference between holy and unholy, and between unclean and clean. All right, so that's under the law, but is this practical today?
Yep.
All right, so you see the word different. So difference. So the whole movement that you have out there in the world is let's get rid of the differences, because the problems come from differences, black and white, male and female. So we're gonna just blur the line. So, you know, Dwayne Wade for the Miami Heat, I saw a picture of him and his family and his boy. I thought it was his daughter's hand. It was a boy, it was his hand, painted nails. And it threw me, I had to look at that again, you know, how you could widen the shot or look closer. It was like a Christmas shot. And it was just a weird angle of this girl's hand beyond him, but it was like, oh, that's the, but then her hand wasn't looking like that when it was the boy's hand. And I opened the box, depends where the box, what's that? Oh, well, turning it out, and, you know, my boy's got different ideas, and of course, Dwayne Wade and his wife, we celebrate his individuality. That's not individuality, by the way, but that's the age, the spirit of this age, brother. And it's leading these little kids and becoming this perversion, amen. And because, you know, Dwayne Wade and his wife are all entertainers. That's all sports is about. And they're now hooked to the machine. So if they were to say anything about it, when 80% of them is pro-sodomite, or if not sodomite themselves, and pedophile, all they're about that entertainment business, they can't say anything about it because they lose their support. And you would be called racist or homophobe or whatever. So they now have to sacrifice their kid to the system. And that's what you'll find in the Old Testament with those Jews with Moloch and stuff and grabbing their kids to walk through the fire. And sadly, you know, if Lot is the type of a Christian in the last days, so you got Noah, speaking of, you know, days leading up to Jesus Christ coming back, right? Second coming. Here's two Bible characters that are referenced, Noah and Lot. Well, Lot would be a good type of your backslidden Christian, brother. Does that happen? Yeah. So if you then now study to show thyself approved. But workmen need not be ashamed. You know, you don't have to be ashamed. You don't have to be ashamed here, and you do not have to be ashamed there. If you study, and to show yourself approved unto God, that's what you do, is to study. So in all the new Bibles, including the New King James, which is not a King James Bible,
amen.
They take out the word study. That's the one that tells you what to do to God approves of what you're doing. Well, as a Christian, would you want to do that? Yeah. So what do I do? Well, we take out the word study, so you wouldn't know that. So you'd have NIV study Bible with no word to tell you to study, no verse. Amen. So you study that deal out, and then all of a sudden you're looking at what Lot was doing as a backslidden Christian or a carnal Christian, man, turning his tent towards Sodom. That's what started it up. Well, watch your TV. You say watch TV? I said watch your TV. You better watch what you were watching, brother, because that's the all comes here. David got caught up with what he saw first. And the devil and Eve, you know, it would appear that it was pleasing to the sight. That was Genesis 3. And so, you know, all of a sudden, man, you know, you got all these kids caught up in what they're seeing. And again, back to that system where they're they're sacrificing their kids. And what Lot did with Sodomites, when you sin, I think it was Manny, that thing with the church and the people coming into the church, the Black Lives Matter or the Tifa group. Well, that's what happened with Lot when the angels, they were coming after him. That's what I saw there. Instead of Lot being a man like he should have been and just resented and repented and got right, or at least put up a fight, he offered those Sodomites perverts his virgin daughter. Now, you know, whatever else was going on to get you to that mindset to think that's the only way we can get out of this situation, brother. Out of all the things, you couldn't have turned and asked these guys for some help. You had an idea of who they were. Instead of you took it upon yourself, and now you were about to hand over your virgin daughters to a bunch of sodomites. Now, to let you know that those daughters weren't completely innocent themselves, is that the end result is of Lot and his daughters wind up drunk in a cave, man, committing incest. And then, you know whose idea it was? It was the daughters. So that's the end day, actually, Christianity, brother. That's a good point of what's going on. So whatever that is, all right, Leviticus chapter 10, verse 10, that they may put a difference between holy and unholy, and between unclean and clean, verse 11, and that ye may teach the children of Israel all the statutes, right, which the Lord has spoken unto them by the hand of Moses. So make sure they know the difference between right and wrong, what's good and bad, right? And then you need to teach the children. You have children now, you better teach them whatever you got to teach them now, brother, because they don't stay young long. They don't stay little long, brother. The time flies, and now all of a sudden they're becoming adults. And brother, a lot of what they see is what they see. And the reason why they typically act the way they do is because they'll pick up that, number one, Christians as parents, Christian parents are all taught. And that you just say one thing in front of whatever, and that's why it's very important. Brother, whatever comments you need to make as a Christian, give them to God. All right, do it like this. Whatever you can't say in front of other people, give it to God. Because other people are going to hear it, and they're going to pick up on the fact, and you start roasting the pastor or roasting other Christians or whatever, and your kids are in the backseat. Say, well, they're just playing, they ain't paying attention. You don't know child psychology then, brother. You don't know human anatomy or development and whatever, and understand the world goes. That's why they are all introducing sodomy into Sesame Street and all the rest of that stuff as little kids. That's why you got sodomites, you know, these transgender, whatever, having library time, and straight white parents with their little kids sitting up in there and getting offended at you when you say, hey, sister, what are you doing? And turning those kids over, whatever. Now, I'm going to tell you about the Black Lives Matter. For the most part, the black communities would be a conservative community. Did you know that? Now, I know the Democrats are getting caught up with whatever, and that's sad. You just got to stand up, man, and got to draw a line. All right, though, but that Black Lives Matter is a homosexual movement, brother. And unfortunately, a lot of people don't read them. They don't take a second to be able to just look and see what it is. And again, that Bible study, you do error not knowing, prove all things, hold true to that which is good, do that. Well, you're not doing it anymore. I'm either afraid, I don't get punched in the face, so yeah, and then the Black Lives Matter people, well, the term Black Lives Matter, that's a positive term, man. There's nothing negative about that. Well, the first thing out of the devil's mouth was the word yes. So it's all positive. So you got to be, oh, no, how can you disagree? Don't Black Lives Matter? And I saw the little girls to the cops, they were saying it. Well, don't they? And the guy said, well, they all do. Well, that's not what we said and all that. We'll give you another chance. What's your badge number? You know, if I'm the cop, I'll be like, psh, they got that. But, you know, you're not supposed to do that, whatever. But now you set that up, that's how they look at authority figures. Little kids. Bro, there's a rod for a reason. And all throughout the book of Proverbs, say, you don't use that rod on your kid, man. That's how they understand it. It's not every day you got to whoop your kid, man. And then I hear these silly parents, they're like, well, if I had to be whooping my kid every day if I did it like that, I would tell you as a father of five, no, you would not. But what you're doing is because you're lazy about how you train your kids up. Training takes time. My wife was the trainer. That's 8-10 hour job, brother, that you train people, spend time going over the the policy and procedure and the techniques, and you know, she did the use of force. She comes in with busted legs and different stuff like that, knees or whatever. It takes time and effort to be able to train up a child. Well, they don't want to do that anymore because they're now working and mama's working now and everybody's tired, and then they just let the kid alone. Well, here's the phone, man. And now you got the kid. You can't even bring the kid to a restaurant. You can't train a kid to behave himself in a restaurant without a phone. And they got the big Apple whatever now, and it's all they're doing is all these things. And you don't know what's going on. You don't know what they're watching. And it's getting in their subliminal or whatever else. So your responsibility is to know that there's differences, right? And know that your responsibility is to teach your kids. According to the Kaiser Family Foundation, kids, right? So they say from 8 to 18. They say kids 8 to 18 now spend an average of 7.5 hours in front of a screen every single day. That's equivalent to a full-time job. 8 hours every day, right? So I did the math. 7.5 times 7 is 52.5. So that's 50 hours a week. Alright? And you multiply that by what? There's 52 weeks in a year. That's 2,730 hours per year that they sit in front of a screen. Brother, if you spend 1 hour a day on an instrument, in 3 years they'll master the instrument. Man, they'll be a master. Piano, whatever. But they're spending almost 8 hours a day on nothing. But watching voodoo, witchcraft, heads being blown off, right? And you can take all the Elmer Fudd deal, take his rifle and whatever from Yosemite Sam, pretend like you're gonna curtail anything. Brother, they're not watching TV. It's not TV, it's a screen. And I'll tell you, the gaming is taking the market share from every other form of media. The gaming industry is taking the market share from every other form of media. It is growing faster than movies and television. So the amount of money spent on video games worldwide, $130 million a year. And they say it's been increasing at 13.3% every single year. It's increasing. And try to bring a kid to have him sit down, which your kids are doing pretty good, man. Right? They're awake. Yeah, you got a lot of parents that take him to church and he'll be asleep. And I preach, well, I go over there, I bang chairs. Not here, I'd have to do that, but other places I'd have to do that. You're teaching your kids what is important and what isn't important, what's right and what's wrong. So we go to church to sleep if you want to. And then you can't figure out when the kids get home, why don't they listen to you? See? You see how that works? Man, you got an opportunity. You only got so long. So I tell my kids at school, I say, well, you're 15, 16, 17. It's like cement. Like you pour cement, right? I've been with contractors, and you got so much time when you pour it to form whatever it is you want to form, and to flatten out or smooth out, whatever, because at a certain thing, it's what it is. And so I tell my kids, well, man, you are about to be who you are going to be for the rest of your life. And I'm looking at some of you, you can't even keep track of a pen and a piece of paper. And every other day is like new hire orientation, man. You got to be represented on why you have to show up with new materials. Right? And that's what you got going on in America, brother. You take a kid, he can't change a dang tire, man. And all he's being is inundated with the occult and sex and drugs, brother. And that's why it's so very difficult, like our little church here. Man, where are those 20 to 30-year-olds, man? Where are they? Where are the kids that are just getting out of the home? They're not in church. Where are they? They're all out, man. Why? Because there's been an undercurrent for their entire life. They're an undercurrent of when you say one thing, the TV that they're watching 7 to 8 hours a day, brother, is saying, no, the occult's okay. Witchcraft is fine. Wizards are great. Magic. It's not the Holy Spirit. It's not the power of the Holy Spirit. It's magic. So Christians are wearing Mickey Mouse and whatever. There's nothing unclean within itself, brother, but you reap what you sow. You can help yourself, man. I'm not saying go away. I watch movies too. You got to be very careful in your movies. You got to be careful what you watch, man. Time, brother. I waste time. I'm like you. All right, go to Exodus chapter 7. talking about spirit stuff.
Oh,
it's out there. What's your whatever's influencing you, brother? Exodus chapter 7. Well, the Wizard of Oz, man, now you look at that like a joke. What's wrong with the Wizard of Oz, man? They're probably showing the Wizard of Oz to churches now. I don't know what we'll time to get. We'll get into it probably next week more so. But I'll give you the history, and I didn't know this. I looked it up. The guy that wrote the book, came out a lot longer than any movie came out. That's always usually how it works, right? When the book comes out and then the movie. Well, that guy that wrote the book, I had no idea about him, man, what he was into. It wasn't no King James Bible. Coming to that. All right, Exodus chapter 7, verse 11. Actually, go to verse 10. And Moses and Aaron went into unto Pharaoh, and they did as the Lord had commanded. Isn't that nice? Can you imagine if you had a church like that? What? The people came in and did what the Lord commanded. What, we would take the whole block over. And we would have, I'm talking Bible believers now. That's all. If you had every Bible believer that knew what they were supposed to do and did it, you wouldn't have enough room in this one to be able to accommodate everybody in South Florida that should be here. But anyway, there's another day. And Moses and Aaron went into the Pharaoh, and they did so as the Lord had commanded, and Aaron cast down his rod before Pharaoh and before his servants and became a serpent. Then, verse 11, Pharaoh also called the wise men and the sorcerers. Now, the magicians of Egypt, they also did in like manner with their enchantments. You see that? So, the magicians and the sorcery and all that, where does that come from? It comes from Egypt.
Okay.
All right, so the occult roots of the Wizard of Oz, right? With its memorable story and its cast of colorful characters, the Wizard of Oz quickly became an American classic. More than 100 years after the release of this book, kids everywhere are still enchanted. I'll read the verse again. Verse 11. Then Pharaoh also called the wise men and the sorcerers, now the magicians of Egypt, they also did in like manner with their enchantments. So they did what God did. God's people did. They did in like manner. How'd they do it? Through enchantments. So you have the power of the Holy Spirit, and then you have the counterfeit. I will be like the Most High.
Okay.
The release of the book, kids everywhere are still enchanted, amen, by Oz's world of wonder. Few, however, recognize that under its deceptive simplicity, the story of the Wizard of Oz conceals deep esoteric truths inspired by theosophy, not theology, theosophy, theosophy. Here, we will look at the Wizard of Oz occult meanings and its author's background. Now, I don't think we'll get into that today, but go to Exodus chapter 8. Right here, 7, go to 8. Look at verse 7, or actually verse 6, and here we go again. So what you need to do is identify what the power of God is and where it comes from. And then you also need to recognize the power of the devil and where it comes from, or that other counterfeit power, right? It's seducing power. Does God Almighty seduce you? No, it's not seduction, brother.
Right.
It's a big difference. Seduction, brother, has a foul end in mind. Seduction.
Yep.
Jesus Christ will call you. He'll court you as a bride, amen. But he will not seduce you. That's the snake. That's the serpent who is more subtle, amen. So a little bit don't hurt. Everybody else does it, right?
Sure.
All right. Exodus chapter 8, look at verse 6. And Aaron stretched out his hand over the waters of Egypt, and the frogs came up and covered the land of Egypt. Verse 7. So when God does something, they'll come right behind him, man, and say, ah, we're good. So when God says do something one way, they'll come right up, like in the Garden of Eden, say, did God really say it like that? But I'll tell you what he really meant. And what problem you have with these little kids here and these young people, becoming young adults, is that they've been convinced through 7.5 hours of media every single day that the grass is greener on the other side. graduates from CCS who made professions of faith and sang in choirs at the school, and they're nowhere near church on Sunday. What happened? It's not how you start, brother. I'm glad you're in it, but it's how you finish.
Amen.
Alright, I understand. Verse 7, and the magicians did so with their, there's that word again, enchantments, and brought up frogs upon the land of Egypt. You know what Disneyland is? That's a counterfeit of New Jerusalem. They call it the Magic Kingdom. You got the kingdom of God and the kingdom of heaven. The devil says, I have the Magic Kingdom. And that's how it works, man. You know, one of Disney's character, man, that mouse has got the wizard deal.
Yeah.
Look at Leviticus chapter 19. Remember, man, the devil ain't come out and show you himself. He didn't do that. He introduced himself a little bit at a time, brother, right? So the Bible says a little leaven, leavening the whole lump. That's why you got Christians all over the world, man. They just look at those Bibles that you can point out. Brother, it's not that that's a different word in your Bible, but Matthew 18:11 is not even in your NIV or your ESV. It's not even in there, brother. And there's 20 other verses like that. It's not that it's a different word, like yours says up and yours says kind of up. That's not even in the book. And you know, you have Christians, they just sit up, you blink at you like a tree full of owls, man. The reason being is because they've been seduced for 8 hours a day, saying that, well, you know, what does it really matter anymore? So you show them truth out of the book, that ain't lining up. Trying to biblical sound doctrine, brother, and Paul said there'll be a time they won't endure sound doctrine, but he can himself teach us having itching ears. Should they'll be turned on to fables. Well, they've been brought up that way. Everything's counterfeit, everything's fake. No cereal, Fruit Loops, there ain't no fruit in Fruit Loops, man. Matter of fact, if you look at the word fruit in Fruit Loops, it's not spelled F-R-U-I-T. That's how you spell it.
Double O-T.
It's double O-T. Yeah. And you would swear that's Fruit Loops. Says fruit, but you're subtle. Ain't no fruit in there, man. That's yellow number 7 and red number whatever and whatever. And America just bought that in entertainment, and that's why you spend millions upon millions on fake stuff. Video games aren't real. Hollywood ain't real, man. Ain't nothing real in that. That guy really didn't fly there. He's not in there playing. Yeah, it's Peter, man. That wasn't World War II. John Wayne wasn't a CD, man. Okay, I know it's crazy. No, he wasn't.
Well, he wasn't the cavalry.
Nah, he wasn't. All right, Leviticus chapter 19. 19:26. You shall not eat anything with what?
Blood.
Now, I ain't getting the bad part right now, but that's twilight. That's all your little kids being introduced with these novels and fiction and love affairs and Dracula and all, man. And vampires are fun. Everybody should be one now. Lord said, I'm good. They have eternal life, right?
Yep.
They got to go through the flesh. And so the devil gets you to think, well, you can live forever in the flesh. You know, again, we'll get into that here. You know how they do those Jews in the tribulation? You're already getting geared to accept everything, brother. You're accepting pedophilia now. How do you know that? Hollywood's full of them, man. Now, some of them stars ain't doing right. They ain't doing very well anymore, so why not? They just start rolling busting everybody. But, brother, they tell you also that Tom Hanks, man, they had that one, but I forget his name. But he was saying about all of them, Steven Spielberg, Tom Hanks, and he dead. They threw him off a bridge. He said he committed suicide. I forget his name. Got curly hair. And I don't know what he was high on or whatever he's doing, but he's making these videos, throwing all these names out there. And he knew it. And he said, well, don't ever do what I did. And I got what I had. I went down the rabbit hole and I found out. And he's talking about Tom Hanks. And then Tom Hanks got his own little deal. And he's posting stuff like roadkill before this kid got thrown off the bridge. Anyway,
that was conspiracy theory.
Conspiracies mentioned several times in the Bible, brother. They just say, oh, you're a conspiracy theorist.
Yeah.
Well, be a student of the Bible and know there's a devil. 26 yet?
No.
Alright, what did I say? 19, 26 or 32?
1926.
That's a good year. You shall not eat anything in your blood, neither shall ye use enchantments, amen, nor observe time. Magic is Egyptian, brother. It's not Christian. Alright, 2 Kings chapter 17. See, the question is, what do you want, Christian? What do you want? You want God to bless you. You're like, yeah, but I want my cake and I want to eat it too, you know? And then when you start drawing lines and separating yourself, see, you're racist or bigot or mean-spirited Christians, and you don't love anybody. Man, I got Bible chapter and verse, brother, to show you why I'm doing what I'm doing. Do you? And they're like, well, as long as you love Jesus, anyway.
If you love me, you'll keep my commandments.
I mean, there's a lot of that. God is cheap, man. 2 Kings chapter 17. 2 Kings chapter 17. Alright, look at verse 17. Now, you wanna know about the... Let's see how people use it. Look at verse 16. And they left all the commandments of the Lord their God. You got to do that first. What did they do? They left all the commandments. So what happened to your school in the 60s? Got rid of all that. Now you got to do that first before you make abortion legal. You got to do that first before you bring the sodomites out of the closet. And they left all the commandments of the Lord their God and made the molten images, even two calves, and made it grow and worship all the hosts of what?
Zodiac.
And serve Baal. So the host, it's army. So the things up in heavens, they're ET and your extraterrestrials, and that's why you get your Star Wars and Star Trek and all those devils. You ever see the characters in any other show? They're always mixed or something. Verse 17. And they, I guess that would be the adults, because adults are writing all the time. And they, especially Christian adults. And they caused their sons and daughters, just like Lot, to pass through fire and use divination and what?
Enchantment.
And sold themselves to do evil in the sight of the Lord, to provoke him to evil, to anger. Sold themselves. That's the entertainment business. You ever see them child actors, man? You ever see what happens? They don't end like that. You ever, and you wouldn't guess it because they're so funny, whatever, but like the Little Rascals, the Three Stooges, and all these little Shirley Temple. You ever read about Shirley Temple, man? How she been molested by those producers and all these different... And Mama knew about it. But the love of money is the root of all you do.
All kinds of.
Alright, 2 Kings chapter 21. 2 Kings chapter 21. 2 Kings 21. So the reason why we've got to change the Bible, the reason why we've got to keep the Bible out of that, because if I'm the devil, man, well, this Bible is a problem with what I got to do, man. It keeps getting in the way. So you Christians call yourself King James Bible believers. Well, how do I do that? Because you know it's the Word of God. I can't take it from you, but I can get it to where you don't ever read it. So it's like, okay, so I got a rifle, but you don't know how to use it. Well, I got an AR, whatever, you don't know how to use it. And if something went down, you'd shoot yourself in the foot. And Christians today all have Bibles. They don't know how to use it. They don't know where the books are. And, you know, if you don't know where the book is, and that's fine. There's 66 of them in the minor prophets. They get a little challenging sometimes. You got an index, right? Problem is you're lazy. And because you want to push a button and just say, hey, Siri. All right, second what, Kings? 21. 2 Kings 21, look at verse
3.
1. And Manasseh was 12 years old when he began to reign, and reigned 55 years in Jerusalem, and his mother's name was Hephzibah. Okay. And he did did that which was evil in the sight of the Lord, which Christians often do. And we forget that God watches everything we do. So you have the kings, they either did right in the sight of the Lord, or they do evil in the sight of the Lord. After the abominations of the heathen, and they act just like the world today, Christians, the abomination of the heathen, it's got the same music, same lifestyle, I want to look like them, I want to sound like them, I want to eat like them, I'm going to live like them, whom the Lord cast out before the children of Israel. So we'll get into, if you want to know about the Indians, I'll let you know about the Indians. But that's what God does. What did God do? He threw people off their land, man. You know who did that? Well, the white man, the Calvary, the government. You know, I know Trump went to Mount whatever with the presidents. Rushmore. So it's the racist presidents on the land that the government threw the Indians off of. You sure it was the government that threw the Indians off the land? Verse 2, I'll read it again. And he did that which was evil in the sight of the Lord after the abominations of the heathen, whom the Lord cast out. The Lord cast them out.
Good.
So you got Kevin Costner, man. We're all going to be in. I had a lady, man. She at work, man, back in the day when I worked with adult mental health. It's quite a lady. She won't be in. So she would always, like, on her days off, go to these reservations and spend the night in the teepees and stuff. You know, Pocahontas got saved, right? You don't see that in the crack. She's talking to trees and stuff. You know what she did after she got saved? She stopped talking to trees. She changed her name, by the way. I think she named herself Ruth or Elizabeth. Right? Elizabeth? Pocahontas. But Disney World, the enchantment, the magic, they're going to show you the heathen part of Pocahontas, not that she got saved and changed her name even. Oh, that was racist. All right, verse 3. And he built up again the high places. Amen? The high places. So in high school, you're always trying to get. All right, so now you do that now legally and everywhere. So anyway. For he built again the high places which Hezekiah's father, he had destroyed. Amen? And he reared up the altars of Baal, got back into it, made it grow, as did Ahab, king of Israel. And here we go again. Worship all the hosts of heaven. So, you know, we don't worship Star Wars, do we?
No.
You sure? Because I mean, I'm not sure what your definition of worship. Because you'll wear a Star Wars shirt many more times than you wear a shirt with scripture on it.
Uh-oh.
And you know where the force comes from, right? That's in the book of Daniel. Huh? Anyway, about it. We're going to change that. Who reads this in? And we worship, and they worship all the hosts of heaven and serve them. Well, what's the definition of serving? Spending time with it, spending money on it, promoting it. When you wear something with, what is that? How do you advertise? Okay. Verse 4. And you build altars in the house of the Lord. You ever seen TV? You ever see how you put on a stand?
Yeah.
I mean, I got a TV, man. I'm just reading Bible here. So, and you build altars in the house of the Lord, of which the Lord said in Jerusalem, and I put my name. Verse 5. And you build altars for all the hosts of heaven in the two courts in the house of the Lord. And he made his son, pass through the fire and observe times. And use enchantments. Here it is again. And dealt with familiar spirits. And now you can't figure out why your boy's kind of looking crazy. Can't sleep at night. And he set the cat on fire. They do that. I worked at adult mental health, bro. I worked juvenile justice for almost 20 years. And I read their files. You know what your kids are turning into now? Sex offenders. Little kids. Man, we made a lot of money. A lot of money to treat them. Treat? How you treat them? Because you let them back out. You ever just go to Publix or Walmart and see the magazines that are all right up in there? And what do you do about that? Because they ain't got no clothes on. And how do you treat this kid there is molesting your neighbor and your daughter? And how you do that? Throw him back in the world. All the music that he's listening to that you promoted has the dancers. organization of women, when you're going against the strip club, when you're going to shout out in contest, in that abusing or whatever women, when's that going to stop? When you're going to cut down all the pornography sites, all the pornography sites in America?
Yes.
They exploit women on it?
Yes.
Now you got the trafficking thing coming out, right?
Miss America.
When are they going, like, oh, you know, that's not fair. You ain't saying a word about it. Okay. You know why, right? We had 5?
Yes.
6. He made his son pass through the fire and observed time. He knows the kids are getting pushed through this stuff. Kids are all getting pushed through this. Big money, man. Disney bought everything up. What does Disney not own anymore? Walmart? That's next. They got Fox. That's your Fox News. And all these Christians.
Oh, Carl Tucker.
Owned by Disney. They have gay parade days or gay days at Disney. For the suckers.
Yep.
That's all it is. They ain't changed nothing. What did Carl Tucker change? What did Rush Limbaugh? Rush has been on since the 90s, brother. I remember we all used to listen to him. What did he change?
Not a thing.
All he kept running, no, Clinton's president, hostage, day number, and he would run that and all the suckers. Meanwhile, overdosing on barbiturates and whatever else. We didn't talk about that. Yeah. And he made his sons pass through the fire and observed times and used enchantments, dealt with familiar spirits, suicide rate amongst kids.
Yep.
You know anything about that? You ever read Mark chapter 5 with the maniac Gadara? You know what he was doing himself? You know what little girls are doing? Cut on
themselves. 8 minutes.
Familiar spirits, wizards, he robbed much. Well, what's connected with wizards, familiar spirits, and enchantments? Much wickedness. Who is that? In the sight of the Lord? Because he watches everything. You know that, right? Does he know your heart? Does he know your works? He eyes the Lord in every place, behold the evil and the good.
Yep.
He knows you're good. He knows you're in church. Excited, I get that you're here. Glory to God. There you are. And what are you going to do when you go home? He sees that too. And you provoke him to anger. He's using corn here. Fear of the Lord is beginning of wisdom, didn't it?
Amen.
All right, let's close with this. Isaiah chapter 47. Instead of just keep preaching and praying and trusting God, we satisfy the flesh. But these two things shall come to thee in a moment. And one day, will many of your kids in there memorize the scripture, singing songs about the Lord, next, gone, dude. All tatted up, full of face piercings, shacked up. Normal. This is good. This is the right road, Daddy. How long did that take? Well, if your life is but a vapor, it didn't take long. And if they're watching 7.5 hours a day worth of witchcraft and enchantment and familiar spirits being seduced by these familiar spirits and seducing spirits, I guess it don't take long, man. Where are they now? You ever seen them shows on TV? Where are they now? Where are they now? They're out in the world. But these two things shall come to thee in a moment and one day. The loss of children and widow and widowhood, they shall come upon thee in their perfection for the multitude of thy sorceries. Of thy sorceries, you lost your kids because of your sorceries. And for the great abundance of thy enchantments. For thou hast trusted in thy wickedness. Thou hast said, none seeth me. Thy wisdom and thy knowledge, it hath perverted thee. And thou hast said in thine heart,
I am and none else beside me.
You know who I am, isn't it?
God.
You know the lie of the devil was, right? You'll be his
God.
That's all it is. That's all you got in church today. People are like, oh, it's big to do. Me first, you next. That's it. Whether it be me and my relationship with my wife, or me and my relationship with my kids, or me and my relationship with the boss, or me and my relationship with God. Me first, you next. And if it pleases me, I'll do it. And if I can tolerate you for a little bit, I might show up. That's all it is. When God said, I got you. I got you number, man. And you look around and you can't figure out what's wrong in America, we keep blaming the Democrats, or you sure? Because that's talking about God's people there. I know it's the Jews in the Old Testament under the law. But I told you that over and over again, man, how you apply that to the individual. And you're in the New Testament. And you're an individual. And how are you doing?
Oh, a little bit don't hurt, Pastor.
Okay. Father, bless the day we thank you for. We love you and thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen. All right. Good job. So.